Getting into medical school wasn't a piece of cake for me at all. I tried twice, and in my first attempt, I failed. And this failure was so painful, it brought my self-confidence down and my self-doubt. It took it up, it skyrocketed my doubt into the sky. But one thing that never changed was my passion for medicine. And this little experience of mine, it taught me one of the greatest lessons I've learned in my life, and I've always held on to. That losing a battle doesn't translate to losing the war. With great determination, there is almost nothing we cannot achieve. My name is Wealth. I'm a second year medical student of the University of Ibadan, and I'm about to share my story, how I got into medical school with an average O-level result. I finished secondary school 2016. When I was preparing for my WAEC, I think I prepared as hard as I could. But by the time the results were released, I had 2 B's, 5 C's, and a D, and also an E. But I was so lucky to have had D and E in my non-compulsory subjects. I had D in Yoruba and E in economics. And it was so unlucky for me that NUC banned posterior me that same year. That is, to gain admission into any university, all you are going to use is your WAEC results, that's your O level and your JAMB. The WAEC was graded over 50, then JAMB over 50. So by the time I calculated the aggregate for my WAEC result, I was on about 28.5. And you know, to get into medical school, you are competing with like the best. I knew I was already behind, I was already losing in the competition, because it really is a competition. Getting into school is actually a competition, because most schools are going to pick the best first before they consider others. So I gave myself an unrealistic goal. I said I was going to score about 380 in JAMB, and it was not like I knew how to do it or anything, but I just said I was going to do all I could. I was going to study as hard. I didn't know it wasn't just about studying, it's about studying right. By 2017, I picked my first JAMB and actually studied hard. I did. I could remember then I would study all day long. I would study my PNOKK physics, my half-ton about biochemistry and my essential biology. And the way I was doing it was I would just open a random page and I would read, but I was always reading at every point in time. But always reading doesn't mean you are reading right. I want you to note that point. Then JAMB came, and by the time I wrote my JAMB, after all my studying, I scored 256. Yes, you might think 256 is a great score, but I knew it wasn't great at all for medicine, even considering the WAEC aggregate I had. So I kind of knew that my dream of studying medicine that year was crushed. But I was just fresh out of secondary school. I practically had no idea of how admission works and all. But I knew, you know, I initially wanted to study in UNILAG, but I knew UNILAG would be competitive. So instead of UNILAG, I chose LASU. I changed to LASU. So I met someone and he advised me against medicine, that there's no way I was going to get medicine with my aggregates. When LASU did the screening and I checked my aggregates, there was no way I was going to get medicine in LASU. So I changed to biochemistry. I was kind of sure I was going to gain admission, because I thought biochemistry is just an ordinary course that anyone could get in with my score then. So I was confident I was going to get it. But I also told my parents I was going to take another JAMB the next year, which was 2018. Then it was time for admission, and LASU really broke my heart. You know, I had already believed I was going to get the admission, and then when they started admitting people, I was on a Facebook group where LASU students, they usually post the admission and like the admission status. So I noticed that people were gaining admission. In fact, some people got below me and they got admission, but they are actually Lagosians. LASU, most state universities do that. They consider Lagosians over other people. I was always checking my admission status, every day before I go to bed in the night. It was always very painful. I kept waiting. I waited for weeks. Weeks was rolling into months. And that was when it began to dawn on me that, oh, but you're not getting this admission, even if it is biochemistry. Then there is one changing moment for me, and I really can't forget this moment. I was at work that day, and my friend Charles, he chose UI then. Then he just called me one afternoon while we were in our workplace to come and check Unilag's admission list. Then the way Unilag published the admission list was that they published the students and their details. Like, I could see the number one on the list, the person that scored highest. I could see the next person, and so, and not just that, they put their grade, their results, their WAEC results, their JAMB and their post-JAMB results. So we checked the first, and even their age. So we begin to check the first 10 people. What I noticed was that every of those first 10, except one, were all 16 years old. And the second thing I noticed was that those people, they didn't just pass their JAMB. Their WAEC was full of A's. Their post-JAMB, out of, I think Unilag post-JAMB is over 30, they scored like 25, 28. I was really angry, like, how could these people that are younger than me do this? Why can't I? So it just fueled the anger in me that I could also do this too. Really, I had no clue how I was going to do it. I just told myself, I'm not getting this year's admission, that 2017. I'm going to start again from the beginning. So I told my mom, my mom and I agreed I was going to take another WAEC. So we went to the school, and on meeting the proprietor, Mr. Sam, he advised against it. He said, instead of writing another WAEC, why don't I pick another JAMB and choose Uni Ibadan, since they don't consider WAEC results. Once you can make your requirements, once you can have at least credits in your 5 core subjects or 6, that the only thing you need to do is to pass your JAMB very well and your post Uni. So I thought about it. It was December 2017. And 2018, I was going to take the next JAMB. With the whole of my savings that I had, I could have asked my parents, but I chose I was not going to that. I took all my money, I went to the bookstore, and I bought the textbooks. I bought my first textbook ever for myself. I still have those textbooks now. I bought Modern Biology, New School Physics, New School Chemistry. And I bought the 4-pass question. The latest one. Then I got an exercise book. I listed the years from 1990 to 2017. That's the year of past question I was going to do, and I was going to be recording my scores in the past question. I mean, in that notebook. I did that, and I also told myself that I was going to study according to the JAMB syllabus, and I will make sure that I follow the JAMB syllabus, and after finishing a topic in the JAMB syllabus, I'm not allowed to fail question from that topic in the past question. If I'm answering the past question and I fail any question at all from that topic I've read before, I have to go back to check. Then I was working. I would get back from work around 4. I would study. During the time I'm studying, I take breaks, obviously. I would study till around 10 p.m. in the night, and from 10 p.m. till 12 a.m. it was just meant for past question. I would solve about 2 years of past question, and not just solve the 2 years, I was going to do correction, and the correction would be thorough, and I was going to make sure that I know the reason why each answer is each answer. I don't just pick the answer and just check the answer without knowing why it was chosen. And the reason for doing this was because I thought to myself that if I can answer all the questions in the past question and know the reason why each answer is the answer, there's no way a new question would be set in my own exam that I wouldn't have met somehow before. If I had not met that question particularly, I've met an idea, a question that is of related idea. I believe you get what I'm trying to say. And actually, that is true. In fact, I could say my exam was when I was studying. When I went to the exam hall, it was not really like an exam for me. It was like I was rehearsing what I've practiced, because most of those questions were things I've seen something that are related to. I can't be sure I saw a question I've seen before directly verbatim, but I'm sure I saw questions that are related to what I've solved sometimes before. So I got to my exam hall and I concentrated as much as I could and I wrote the exam. After the exam, I had a sense of relief because I knew I did it well. So 2 days later, my result came out. I scored 323. I was really happy. Like after my jam, there's no much story for my post-TME. I just basically did what I did for my jam. I scored 77, and by the time I calculated the aggregate, my aggregate was 78.765, if I'm not mistaken. And the post-TME, the cutoff mark came out, and the cutoff mark was 76.5. So that was how I got into medicine UI. So I'm going to give you like just 4 pieces of advice. The first thing is that hard work pays. There's no, if you want something, just work hard for it. The second one is that determination. You need to be determined. Know what you want first. If you know what you want, then you can work hard for it. The third piece of advice I'm going to give you is that you can't put the place of God away. Like, you know, there's a limit to what we can do, and just let it unto God. And that is the end of my story. I'm tired of talking. And please subscribe and like and share. Please share. You can share this message to as many people as you can. See you in the next video. Bye.